Hi everyone. Today in this video we'll see what is the difference between EMI and no cost EMI. So let's get started. So nowadays we are listening this term called no cost EMI in many places. Like previously only Bajaj Finserv card used to offer the no cost EMI, but now we are even seeing the no cost EMI option available on like the famous shopping websites like Amazon, Flipkart as well. So I'll try to explain you the difference between EMI and no cost EMI. So what is an EMI? EMI is like equated monthly installments or easy monthly installments or equal monthly installments. So for example, if you have purchased an item of rupees 10,000 cost and you choose an option called EMI to pay in 9 months or 12 months, then for example, instead of 10,000 rupees item, take 12,000 rupees item. 12,000 rupees item, if you pay in a span of 12 months, then you can pay it in 1,000 per each month instead of all 12,000 in one single month. So this is a very good option for people who do not have the liquid cash, huge liquid cash in hand. 12,000 might not be a big amount, but for example, if you buy any high-end TV or a laptop or anything, the item cost would be around 50,000 or 60,000. And spending 60,000 in one single shot is not possible for everyone. So what they do is generally they opt for an EMI option. EMI option is like we can pay the splitted amount in many months instead of one single month. So if you take the 60,000 rupees item and you agree to pay in 12 months, then you have to pay 5,000 each month instead of 60,000 per month. So even a person who draws a net income of around 20,000 can afford a 60,000 item if he can pay just 5,000 every month instead of paying the whole amount. I have made one more video on EMI. You can check it out on the right top to know more information. So coming to the no cost EMI. So EMI option is provided to you for some overhead. So bank is giving you this option, or the financial institution is giving you this option to pay over multiple months, then they'll charge you some extra. That is the interest. For example, in the 60,000 example, you are just paying 5,000 per every month, and the total amount you will be paying is at the end of 12 months. So in this 12 months, the bank has to pay the product seller the 60,000. So it works in this way. You buy the electronic item like laptop or anything which is costing 60,000 through bank instead of directly. If you buy through bank or through your credit card or some EMI scheme, then what does bank do is the bank will pay 60,000 to the product seller. So the product seller will be getting the 60,000 in the beginning itself. Then you will be paying the extra amount to the bank instead of the seller. So the bank will be taking the 60,000 from you. As bank is taking it partially from you, it will collect some interest from you depending upon the tenure you choose. Like 3 months they'll be having a tenure, 5 months, 6 months and 9 months they'll be having a tenure, like that. Mostly it'll be like 13% or 15% you'll be charged. Okay, then what is no cost EMI? The main difference is, as you see on the screen, it is no interest. So the extra charge which the bank is putting on you, that is the 13% or 16% or 15% which you are being charged extra for paying in installments, is being taken off or is being waived off. So you just have to pay the 60,000 instead of paying it in one single shot, you can pay in multiple months. So one reason why banks do this is like banks don't directly do this. This might be an option being given from the product sellers to increase the product sales. For example, if many people are interested to buy their product, But because of the heavy cost, they are unable to buy. But if this kind of option is available, then many people can afford it. As I have said, even a 20,000 net income person can buy an item which is worth 60,000 if he has to pay just 5,000 a month. So the purchasing capacity will be improved of the people when they offer this kind of no interest scheme. So that is what is called as no interest EMI, or that is called as or no cost EMI. So you end up paying only the 60,000 at the end of 12 months instead of paying 13% or 16% extra interest when you buy through EMI option. So that is the main difference. So how are they being provided this? Because according to RBI rules, the credit cards should not provide no interest EMIs. But there is an option called Bajaj Finserv cards. This is an exact actual no cost EMI because they don't come as a credit card, they come as a product purchasing card. So it's like an actual no cost EMI. But when you come to the credit cards, it'll be like the amount of extra interest, that is for 60,000, for suppose the interest amount is some 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees for a span of 12 months, then that 1,000 or 2,000 rupees, instead of you paying extra, the product seller would be giving it as a discount to you. So that is a 60,000 rupees item would be bought at a cost of 58,000 rupees, and you end up paying 60,000 only along with the interest. So effectively, you'll not be paying anything as interest. So that is one type of no cost EMI. So when you are buying through credit cards, this kind of method is being practiced because I have bought one or two items through credit card no cost EMI. So if it's a credit card no cost EMI, then you'll be getting an initial discount of some percentage, which is equal to the interest percentage of that particular amount. So when both of them will be as both of them will be equal, so you will not be paying effectively any interest, and that will be similar to no cost EMI. But there will be some charges, some GST charges, which are standard for credit card EMI transactions, but that will be there. So that will be very minimal. That will be on the interest. For example, if it's a 1,000 rupees interest, on 1,000 rupees it will be 18% GST. That will be some 180 rupees or something for that span. So that is nominal. So if you cannot if you need the item at any cost, then the best way is if there is a look out for a no cost EMI option, and if that is available, then you can go for that, or you can wait. Most of the time during some sale or festival seasons, the big shopping sites or the big banks are offering no cost EMIs. So you can go and purchase through that, and you end up just paying some nominal charges instead of paying the extra interest, and you're getting the luxury of buying the item with partial payments instead of full payment. So this is a great benefit. You can go through no cost EMI. Hope I could explain you the difference between EMI and no cost EMI, and how no cost EMI is works on credit cards and how it works on Bajaj Finserv cards. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any other queries, let me know through the comment section related to this topic or any technical topics. You can post me a question in the comment section, or if you have any suggestions for this video, you can also post them so that I can improve this video. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Do like this video if you have found this useful, and share with your friends if you feel it will be useful to them. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more informative videos. Thanks. Have a nice day.
You say you wanna try, but you never do.